You think you know me?
Hello everyone, welcome back to Ratchet and Clank 3 Up Your Arsenal. In the last episode we did stuff and today we are going to shoot a movie at Holostar Studios.
Jeeves, activate the cloaking device.
With pleasure, sir. Now you see us, now you... Oh, crud.
Cut, cut, that's it! You've disgraced my set for the last time, kid. Take up basket weaving, you're fired! Get me the monkey.
I'll see you at the trailer, Clank.
Agent Clank, meet your new sidekick. All right, forget the chase scene and go right to the grand finale. You did read the script I sent you. First, you narrowly survive a series of death-defying stunts, yada yada. You defeat the terror of Talos, yada yada yada. Finally, you rescue the Baroness, played by the lovely Miss Courtney Gears.
Okay.
And action!
All right, this is the part where you take out the henchmen, then chase Maximilian out of the bar. Try to make it look real, all right? Action!
All right, make it real. Right, all right. Punch everything. So, yeah.
You got this stuff, kid. Now get to Maximilian's office before he can make his escape. Okay, Clank is hot on his tail. Maximilian tries to shake him off in rush hour traffic. All right, I love a good chase scene.
Yeah, the thing is that it's kind of hard to commentate because, you know, the cameraman is giving you directions and stuff like that. This is going for the outtakes, by the way. The reason is that I'm gonna play machines, slot machines.
Great, kid. Now, avoid the lasers and meet up with the monkey in the casino parking lot.
Yeah. It's outtake, I'm gonna play slot machine. They are a little bit different than in second game. Because now you have to match three icons. Instead of three pieces of icon, instead of, you know, three icons that need to be matched. And the skill point is exactly what you think. Get a jackpot. Now it is going to take forever to happen, which is the reason why I'm doing it right here, because there's a whole bunch of these machines. It doesn't take forever when I want to reset. I'd love to see how they edit this together, but don't worry, we will cut this out in the final movie, or the final edit, and we'll actually do it properly. I'm running out of slot machines. I'm looking for that black box with yellow. Whatever. Steady. Shut up. Nope, not getting it. I'm just getting money. This costs 10 volts, by the way, to spin the slot machine. I mean, they will come up later, but since this is really close to the beginning, might as well do it right away.
Acting, Clank. Look it up.
Sorry, get rid of the lasers because they are going to kill me otherwise. Alright, I'm gonna look. That is what you want, but we just want the top part. Basically, that top part right there. So, that is what we want, and I know for certain that we are not going to be getting it during this part. But I just wanna let the jackpot machine roll, because I'm pretty certain that it takes like maybe 100 spins before the jackpot can happen, because I believe it is pretty much scripted. You just play the slot machine for a certain amount of time and then it happens. Also, while I remember, let's do the backup save. Right there, there we go. That's the backup save. Ah, there we go. Well, let's reset.
Cut! One more time, people, like we rehearsed it. And action!
Like we rehearsed it. There we go.
Now get to Maximilian's office before he can make his escape. Okay, Clank is hot on his tail. Maximilian tries to shake him off in rush hour traffic. All right, I love a good chase scene. All right, you're doing great, kid. Now, avoid the lasers and meet up with the monkey in the casino parking lot.
Again, I would probably just go and play slot machines now if I wanted to, but let's just move on. I remember when if you just play the jackpot once and destroy all the machines, you should be good to get it later. Shut up. I'm gonna be talking over him a lot, by the way, so 2 second delay, sorry. We actually need the monkey this time, so bring along. Get my handy bots with me again. It's pretty generic stuff. How would Ratchet Clank get across while I'm playing as him, so no need to pretend because I know what I'm doing. Ah. Usually the bots stop before the laser, or before the lasers can be a problem, but this time they didn't. Right, two more ninjas. With the same visor as in Ratchet has in Ratchet Gladiator. Interesting. I have no idea what's the point of this, it's just there. There's no point for this being here. It doesn't do anything. But I'm gonna break it anyway.
I love it! Okay, this is it, people. The grand finale, Giant Clank versus the Terror of Talos. Don't screw this up, kid. Action!
So interestingly, they don't actually tell you the controls for Giant Clank bot. But they The controls are pretty much identical to the second game.
Right, you, the giant ninjas.
And I mean completely identical. Right, we have to go and fight six ninjas. The best way to get rid of them is to stomp on them. And no, punching helicopters doesn't give you health this time. And there's no health anywhere, so you just have to be fast with these guys. Because you will run out of health. Right. We got rid of the first six, now we have to battle six more. Also, just realized we are fighting Thug for less ships. So this really is Ask Ratchet & Clank 2 remake. They didn't change anything, they didn't model change the ships. Which may or may not be a nice throwback to the second game, or it just laziness. It's one of them. Hello. Yeah, hit him with the kung fu. Where is the thing? There it is. And now we have to battle the boss with ninjas coming. Don't bother with the ninjas unless they just want to get stepped on. Nice sensor, nice lag as well. Yeah, this bit lags for whatever reason. It lags. Stay on the dinosaurs! And there we go, I win.
Put it in the can and it's a wrap. Take five, people.
Ah, there we go. Then we just wait.
All in a day's work.
Cut! Printed! That's a wrap, people!
Pure box office raritanium, Clank. Even the critics are gonna love it.
You have no idea what a thrill it is to be rescued by a big hunk of titanium alloy like yourself.
Perhaps now you will tell me what Dr. Nefarious is planning.
I have a better idea. Why don't you ask him yourself?
What is it?
I have a present for you, Snooky Wookums.
Agent Clank!
Of course, darling.
Where am I? Is someone there? I seem to...
Agent Clank, it is an honor to finally make your acquaintance. I have been following your exploits ever since your first mission, when you defeated the mind-stealing stop beasts from Dimension X.
I believe there has been a misunderstanding. Secret Agent Clank is merely a fictional character I play on the horror video.
Lies! Squishy lies!
Oh, Lem, I can't. It's not right. You're my cousin's uncle's son.
Lies! You are a hero to robots across the galaxy, and yet you deny your own destiny. You choose to bow and scrape before the squishies! Where is your pride in who you are, Agent Clank?
Organic life forms have as much right to inhabit this galaxy as we do. I see no reason to exclude
them. And I will give you a reason. Join me, and together we will rule an entire galaxy of robots. Or refuse. Remain a traitor to your own kind, and follow your beloved squishies into the black hole of oblivion!
Clank should have been back by now. What could be taking him so long?
Oh god, we are being ambushed! With new enemies, these green dudes, they are annoying. And I mean annoying, because they do a whole lots of damage, as you can see. Anyway, here's the main part of the 42. The Holostar Studios Lot 42. This is where we're supposed to go. This area back here is something we cannot access. And you can see that there's boxes over there. And a spiraling thing that goes into the sky. We'll talk about that once we get there. What weapons do we have? Like new stuff. We have the Rift Inducer, which we actually need to 100% the game. Also, this is kind of an interesting thing, interesting level, because of, you know, we don't have Clank at all. So we come back to Ratchet & Clank 2 early parts, where we didn't have Clank, so we only had to play as Ratchet. Charge boots are things that I do not want at this point. Here's Rift Inducer, by the way. It sucks enemies in. Any sort of size. So just drop it in middle, go hiding, and it will clear the enemies for you. The price you pay for having that ability is the fact that it doesn't have that much ammo. Also, this is kind of a difficulty spike, but not really, because Dax was a little bit tougher than this level, so I don't consider this to be a difficulty spike. More just a continuation of the Planet Dax. Also, those guys are tough. even though it didn't seem like it, because I used Flux Rifle. I know that there's one over back there. Or maybe that was just it. Why do I keep going for a charge attack when I can't obviously have it? Yep, it's kind of obvious that we're going over there, and if I were to clip through this, I could. However, I won't, since, you know, we're doing stuff, like not playing the game properly. Oh boy, another hacker mission. That is actually the maximum you can do in a single hacker. Our single hacking mission is 4 rounds. Also, kind of an interesting-ish story. When I was playing through this game for the 5th time, or my 5th challenge mode playthrough, I got stuck here because it was a little bit too fast-paced for me. So, I just ran out of skill. But, yep. I managed to go through it after so many tries. It wasn't that bad. It wasn't like, you know, Jack 2 swamp mission that got me like rage quit the whole game. That still remains the only time I've ever rage quit in a video game. I've never rage quit before that, and all since. Now there's green one, there we go. And now we get to see the red layout. If you want to succeed easily in these hacking missions, always go for the red ones first, unless you know you're really close to the end, then you go for the green ones. We got an elevator, which leads us into more enemies. I'm just gonna fire this so I can get rid of the little guys and get... I'm just gonna go get this trophy, which appropriately is the Clank trophy. So the little guy should be gone. I'm gonna try to snipe the green guys because they are just annoying, because they take 5 million hits normally, and they can two-shot you easily. Like really easily, just two-shot you if you're not paying attention. Also, I'm gonna go and get this titanium bolt back here, and then we got more slot machines. Yep, this is the second part where you can play the slot machines. And usually if you destroy all the ones in the Clank section, you should be getting, or should be able to get the jackpot here. Also, it's kind of good to refill your ammo with. So. Box that I missed. I would still recommend staying away from them because they do a lot of damage. Way more than the one in... Yep, this is the jackpot that we went for. That right there is the one that we wanted. And we got it. So now we can move on into more hacker puzzles. They just really love the hacker in this game, because it's everywhere. Hacking is kind of like, it's every... You do it a lot when you get it, and after that it kind of just... dies after that. I mean, like, after this we won't be doing it for a while. Not including the Aquato's secret one. Because, as the title says, it's a secret one. We don't have to do it in order to progress. Also, I did kind of spoil an end game thingy. The challenge mode is back from the previous games. Basically, you keep all your bolts and health and weapons, but you lose all of your items, and you play through the game again. I usually never bother with that. Except for this game and a Cracking Time, those are the two games that I've done Challenge Mode plenty of times, and Gladiator for different reasons. Hold on. Whenever you use the hacker, this thing goes away, so you have to reopen this whole thing. Get it going. Also, ambush, nice. Get in there. The Rift Inducer is a really good weapon. If the enemies can be sucked up, because if the enemies are a bit too big, they won't be able to get sucked. But it's really good just to get rid of the small guys. Like, against these ships, it's kind of, well, it's useless, let's be honest. Also, that's the very first time we've gone head to head with a dropship. Okay, I'm gonna go sideways a little bit because I wanna tell about a thing. That platform over there, I've reached that area over there, but there's an invisible wall, so just don't bother. This is how you swing sideways, by the way, into areas that you're supposed to be going to. And you can snipe this if you want. No real point to it though, because you're taking time away from your good weapons. I'm gonna get rid of you and then go and just display everyone. So the attack button, he shoots 3 times and then you're good. More health is always appreciated. The door is open up back there. And that is where the item shop was. Back there, so we can't over here. Ah, the green guy is shooting at me, apparently. Interesting. You know, any weapon or display gun, I might as well take that. Refill that. Go into sniping mode. That nice double kill right there. I have no idea why this guy is shooting at me, because I didn't aggro him in any way, but he was, so. This switch right here switches between rain and snow. Even though I hate snow, I think snowfall is better than just regular rain. So as it comes down, if it stays on the ground, then no, water. Definitely water. I just want to get this thing leveled up, that's the reason why I'm using it. Also, when you get rid of those green guys, those guys appear. Let me just get my Rift Inducer. And I think this is the first time I've leveled up a weapon in the same level I've obtained it. So interesting development right there. Snipe you, no scope, and that's the end of the level. As you can see, our ship is here, and Clank.
Clank, where have you been? I thought something happened to you.
I was having my sprockets lubed.
You picked a fine time for a tune-up. Where's Courtney Gears?
Miss Gears has left the planet.
What? What about Nefarious? Did she tell you where he is?
Dr. Nefarious is aboard a star cruiser called the Leviathan.
Okay. Nice job, Clank. So, I'll just call Sasha and have her track down that star cruiser.
You okay there, buddy? It probably was nothing. Anyway, this is the reason why I wanted to go to Analyze Nation first, to reduce backtracking. Also, that is close to where we started the level. Yep, because if you come to this planet first and then go to... No, not this planet, you go to Obani Gemini and then come to this one. If you complete this level before, you know, Blackwater City and that, you don't get the magnet boots, which means you have to backtrack. This is the reason why I got magnet boots first. Because that brings us into a completely different area. with completely different music. Yep. I have no idea what the point of this area is or why there's different music, but there just is. Also, screw you. Get sucked. And another one. So, a nice completely optional area for you to go through. Hold on, I need to snipe some people. Close to level up. Maybe after this we get a level up. We will not. Damn it. But luckily the enemies are pretty weak. You know, these guys. Not too much of a problem. If there were green guys, then oh boy, that would have been a bit of a problem. Now you can see that there's something that goes over there. And this just goes up there. I can't actually remember if there is anything interesting, but the way to get on this other rail is to do... Someone's shooting at me. A suicide jump, which means jumping off and hovering down onto it. So now we're on this rail instead of the other one. Which means that I've gone the wrong way, so I have to go and do that again. It's easy to get turned around when you do this. Did I get the right one? Yes, I did. It's kind of important to do this, because if you don't have the map-o-matic, by the way, spoilers, you'll be missing like stuff like this. This whole area doesn't even show up on the map at all. Also, piss off. Yep, this whole area doesn't appear on the map at all. Anyway, that's the secret that you can easily miss. Even with the map-o-matic, you can easily miss that. Except that here you're supposed to be seeing it, but if you don't know it's there, it's easy to miss. Oh god. I'll take my level up. I shot you in the back and you didn't die. The hell. That right there is the start area, right there. So if you know if you are speedrunning this game, you probably skip this level. But if you wanted, you could just clip through this, go up here. And you know, you're supposed to be avoiding these guys, but you can just, you know, lava gun your way up there. Get titanium bolt and teleport here. Back here. And be done. And that should be all of Holostar Studios. Hold on, let me just get my rectinducer back and we're good.
Yo, dudes!
Hey, Skid. How's the stakeout going?
Awesome! A few minutes ago, this totally tricked-out space limo rolls up, and dude, you won't believe who was in it! Courtney Gears!
Uh-oh. Were you spotted?
No way, man! I've been staying out of sight, keeping a low profile. I'm like a shadow, dude.
And you're sure it was her?
Totally! She even autographed my t-shirt!
Ugh.
You know how much this thing is worth?
Skid, get out of there!
Hold on a sec, bro. Somebody's coming. Hey, if you dudes are here about the shirt, the bidding starts at 300 bolts. Whoa, chill out, man. Hey!
Skid's in trouble. We better get back to the Obani Moons.
Oh, crap. God damn it, Skid.